माय सेल्फ मिस तेजश्री कोसबे, लेक्चरर फ्रॉम प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक भाईंदर. माय सब्जेक्ट इज मेंटेनेंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इक्विपमेंट. इन दिस चैप्टर 3 इज टेस्टिंग एंड मेंटेनेंस ऑफ रोटेटिंग मशीन्स पार्ट 14. लर्निंग आउटकम्स. एट द एंड ऑफ दिस वीडियो यू विल लर्न अबाउट कॉमन ट्रबल्स इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंस्टॉलेशन, फैक्टर्स इन्वॉल्व इन डिजाइनिंग मशीन फाउंडेशन, requirements for installation of transformers, the requirements of foundation for rotating electrical machinery, and procedure for leveling and aligning of direct coupled drive. So first is common troubles in electrical installation. So first trouble is foundation not strong. Second is foundation structure, nut bolt not aligned properly. Third is concrete foundation if not cured for a period of time may create problems. Next is there may not be sufficient space for foundation or around foundation to fix accessories. Fifth one is sufficient space around the installation may not be available for the operator to operate the control devices. Sixth is may produce vibration if installation is not horizontal and rigid. Next topic is factors involved in designing machine foundation. Following information is required to start the foundation. First is drawings of machine from foundation design point of view. Second is dimension of the machine, that is its length and width. Next is height of machine. Third is information about condition of soil, that is bearing capacity of soil, soil density and groundwater table location. Next factor is weight of machine, that is erection weight, operating weight, imposed weight, accessories weight. Fifth one is CG location in static and operating condition. Sixth is level of plinth should be above the maximum flood level of the site. Seventh is groundwater level. Eighth is whether machine is static, rotating or reciprocating. Ninth is surrounding atmospheric condition. 10th is earthquake resistance should be considered while designing foundation. Next is the foundation should be able to absorb the vibration while operating at its full capacity. 12th is the dimension of foundation should be proportional to safe bearing capacity of soil. So these are the factors which are considered while designing the foundation. Next is requirements of for installation of transformers. So first requirement is near load center. So transformers should be located near load center to reduce cost of transmission and distribution lines and to reduce losses in it. Second is easy access for transmission line. So there should be easy access for incoming and outgoing line. Third is easy access toward transformers. So there should be easy access towards for transformer for transportation of equipment and manpower, etc. Fourth requirement is space, that is land available. So transformer, the land proposed for a transformer should be normally level and open from all sides. Next is bearing capacity of land, that is hard land. To reduce erection cost and for better foundation of transformer, land should be have high bearing capacity, that is it should be hard soil. Sixth is area free from earthquake. So to avoid damage to transformer area should be free from earthquake. Seventh is transformer should be installed only on poles strong enough to carry their weight. Eighth is transformer poles should be straight. Next topic is the requirements of foundation for rotating electrical machinery. So first, consider static weight of the machine and accessories. Second, also consider the operating weight. Third is the foundation should be able to carry the superimposed loads. Fourth is the foundation should be able to absorb the vibration while operating at its full capacity. Fifth is the foundation should be sufficiently rigid to maintain proper alignment between the motor and the drive and machine. Sixth requirement is the foundation should be sufficiently rigid to withstand the possible horizontal thrust caused by machine while in operation. Next requirement is the dimension of foundation should be proportional to safe bearing capacity of soil. Eighth is the dimension of foundation block should be sufficient that the resultant of all the forces should pass within the foundation block. Next is the combined center of gravity of machine and foundation should be as far as possible be in the same vertical line. Next is for concrete foundations, use concrete ratio of 1:2:4. 11th is the foundation should be well cured before machine put on it. 12th is the depth of foundation should be proportional to the bearing capacity of soil. Next is level of plinth should be above the maximum flood level of the site. 14 is the surface of foundation must be protected from machine oil by means of suitable chemical coating or suitable chemical treatment. 15 the following size of depth of foundation, that is for rating of motor, that is up to 10 HP, the size of depth of foundation should be 7.5 to 10 cm deep. For 10 to 25 HP rating of motor, size of depth of foundation should be 15 to 20 cm deep. For 25 to 50 HP, size of depth of foundation should be 20 to 25 cm deep. For 50 to 75 HP motor, size of depth of foundation should be 25 to 37.5 cm deep. And for 75 to 100 HP motor, size of depth of foundation should be 37.5 to 60 cm deep. Next is procedure for leveling and aligning of direct coupled drive. So procedure for leveling and aligning of direct coupled drive is align the motor and the driven machine on bed plate. Firstly, align axis of both the shafts in the same line and not make an angle with each other, that is axial positioning of the shafts. Next is align both the shafts correctly in the vertical and horizontal plane, that is paralleling of shaft axis. Next step is align both the shafts correctly on the same center axis, that is centering of shaft axis. Next step is any variation in levels is corrected by suitable steel shims, that is steel packing plates. It is leveled by adding or removing shims. To check alignment, there are three methods for checking the alignment. First is by visual inspection combined with stringent or ruler. This method has less accuracy. Next method is by use of dial indicator. This method has high accuracy. Third method is by use of laser guided tools, and this method has also highest accuracy. Next topic is effect of misalignment on the performance of machine. So there will be excessive vibrations. This is the first effect. If there is a misalignment, then it produces excessive vibrations. Next is increased noise level. Third is the shaft will bend. Fourth effect is increases in friction loss. Fifth is premature bearing and coupling failure. Sixth is premature failure of belt, rope, chain in case of indirect drive. Seventh, it increases maintenance cost. Eighth, it increases energy consumption. Next effect, it reduces motor efficiency. Tenth is overall performance of machine reduces. 11th is early wear and tear of both driving and driven machine. 12th is loose or broken foundation bolts and coupling bolts. 13th effect is high bearing temperature. And 14th is high lubricating oil temperature. So these are the effects of misalignment. Thank you.